We will learn statistics. Statistics is a branch of mathematics which deals with collection of information, analysis and interpretation of data. In class 9, you have studied the classification of given data into ungrouped as well as group frequency distribution. You have also learned to represent the data graphically, such as bar graph, histogram, frequency polygon, etc. In fact, you have also learned measures of central tendency like mean, median, mode. We know that mean is nothing but sum of scores divided by number of scores. Median is the middlemost score of the observation when arranged in ascending order. And mode is the most often repeated score. So in this video, we are going to learn how to find out mean for ungrouped data as well as grouped data. Now let us take a simple example. Suppose in a class of 5 students, they have got marks like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 in a test of out of 10 marks. Let us find out the arithmetic mean of these scores 2, 4, 6, 8. We know mean is equal to sum of scores divided by number of scores. So I am going to add these scores now. 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10. And total how many scores are there? 5 scores are there. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Divided by 5. So we have 30 divided by 5, which is equal to 6. So total number, so the arithmetic mean is 6. Sum of scores divided by number of scores. Now let's see how to find out mean of group data. Suppose in a class, 3 students has got 10 marks, 2 students has got 20 marks, 5 students has got 30 marks, 2 students again has got 40 marks, and finally 3 students has got 50 marks. So the marks obtained will be our scores, that is xi. We usually denote it as xi. x1 means first score, x2 means second score. In general, xi means the scores. And frequency, since 3 students has got 10 scores, the frequency will denote as fi. That means the score 10 is repeated 3 times. The score 20 is repeated 2 times. So fi in general, it means frequency. Now how will you find the arithmetic mean for this data? This is the group data because scores and the frequencies are there. And we know that in 9th standard you have studied the mean formula is sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. Mean is usually denoted by x bar. So x bar is equal to, this is the symbol for summation, and we call this symbol as sigma. Sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. Sigma fi means total of these frequencies. So when you add, we'll get 15. Now we have to find out what is sigma fi xi. For that, first we have to find out fi xi. Fi xi is nothing but multiply 10 into 3, so we have 30, 20 into 2, 60, 30 into 50, 150, 40 into 2, 80, 50 into 3, again 150. So this is fi xi, just we have to multiply the score and the corresponding frequency. So when you total this, you will get 470 is the total, and we have to find the arithmetic mean. This x bar is equal to 470 divided by the total, that is 15. So when you divide this, you will get 31.33 is our arithmetic mean. Now let's see how to find out arithmetic mean of group data with the class interval. So 10 to 25, number of students 2. That means the student who has got mark between 10 and 25 is 2. Same way, the number of students who has got marks between 25 and 40 is 3. Number of students who has got marks between 40 and 55 is 7. We call 10 to 25 as a class interval. Earlier classes you have studied that in a class interval 10 to 25, 10 is called as lower limit and 25 is called as upper limit. Same way, in the class interval 25 to 40, 25 is called as lower limit and 40 is called as upper limit. Now, we have to find out arithmetic mean for this group data. So, the arithmetic mean formula is mean is equal to sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. But from how will you find out xi? Since it is a class interval, how will you find out the class mark? The class mark of the class interval is nothing but upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Suppose we want to find out the class mark of the class interval 10 to 25, we have to do 10 plus 25 divided by 2. That is 35 divided by 2, which is equal to 17.5. So the class mark is nothing but midpoint of the class interval, and you can get it by upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. So that will give you xi. Same way, fi is there and we have to find the fourth column as fi into xi like previous sum. So we will first find out the class mark of these class interval. If you do 25 plus 40 divided by 2, we will get 32.5. Same way, the next will be 47.5, 62.5, 77.5, 92.5. Now we will multiply 2 into 17.5, that is 35, 97.5, 332.5, 6 into 62.5 is 375.5, 465.5 and 505.5. We need to total this and the second column to get sigma fi and sigma fi xi respectively. So when you total this, you will get 30, and this one when you total, you will get 1860, which is equal to 1860 divided by 30, which is equal to 62. So the arithmetic mean for this group data is 62. So in this video, we have seen how to find out arithmetic mean for three types of question. One is an ungrouped data like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. You need to just add these scores and divide by number of scores. The second one is if the score 10 is repeated 2 times, score 20 is repeated 3 times, the score 30 is repeated 4 times, how will you find the arithmetic mean? So this will be xi and this will be fi. You have to find out third column fi into xi, and you need to find out the arithmetic mean by using the same formula, sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. And third type of problem is how to find out when the class interval and the frequency is given. So when the class interval is given, one additional step you need to find out, that is you have to find out xi or class mark. Class mark is upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Then you have to multiply with the corresponding frequency. Again, you have to use the same formula. Mean is equal to sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. Arithmetic mean is also denoted like this, x bar. And the arithmetic mean is also called as average. So, thank you for watching this video.